Leonardo da Vinci once said that the noblest pleasure of life is the joy of understanding.
15th century Renaissance, Florence, Italy, Platonic Academy.
Dear Mr. Reuter, we accept we had to spend a whole Saturday working on this essay for whatever we did wrong. Some of the things which we did were wrong, but we think you're crazy to make us write this essay telling you who we are. What does anyone care? You see us as you want to see us, in the simplest terms and the most convenient definitions. You see us as a thinker,
a rebel,
a ruler.
Correct? That's the way we saw each other at 7 o'clock this morning. We were brainwashed.
Well, 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 here we are. I'd like to congratulate you. Sir, I think this was a mistake. I mean, I know it's detention, but I don't think I belong here.
You guys have the next 8 hours to write a 1,000-word essay on who you are, what you want, and how you want to affect the world. My office is right down the hallway, so don't try any monkey business.
If you keep eating your hand, you're not going to be hungry for lunch.
No one here is interested in what you have to say.
Whatever, thinker. How'd you get in here anyway?
Well, I was just trying to achieve excellence, even if I had to break the rules, which I did.
What do you mean you broke the rules?
Well, I dissected some bodies, and the Pope didn't like that so much, so he kicked me out of Rome. That didn't stop me, though.
Why did you dissect dead bodies?
I believed in achieving excellence in everything I did, whether it be as an engineer, a scientist, an artist, or a military commander. I was constantly seeking knowledge by working, studying, and applying my research. I created many inventions such as the bicycle, pedometer, magnifying glass, alarm clock, gas mask, life preserver.
Whoa, dude, chill out, we get it. You're a nerd.
Well, what'd you do to get in here anyway?
Well, you could have called me a bit of a rebel. I wrote of human dignity, which I wrote to introduce the Roman disputation, and argue that God created Adam with free will.
Can you, clarify that statement more, please?
Well, these days most people believe God will punish people if they do something for their own good that wasn't for the church. They'd think it was a sin. You know what? I'll show you guys. We can go to my locker. I have my 900 theses from different points in philosophy taken from many different schools of thought where I include ancient, medieval, pagan, Christian, Muslim, and Jewish writings.
We can't leave. We're gonna get in trouble.
Live a little, Da Vinci. Let's go! Come on, right this way.
Locker 2A147. Here's my 900 theses.
Is that candy?
Shh.
Candy? Keep it on the down low. This candy's not just for anyone.
Candy?
See, ancient, medieval, pagan.
Shh. We gotta get out of here.
Those kids.
Oh my god, guys. Walking to school just brings back all this knowledge, and oh, I just gotta share. So the Platonic Academy, it was originally created by Cosimo de' Medici, who's actually Lorenzo's father. And when a friend of his convinced him to create this group of some of the best philosophers and artists and writers, it was really more of just a club of a couple of the best thinkers and some students, rather than an actual, like, academy school kind of thing. Then Lorenzo eventually took over afterwards when he started to lose money in the banking business. And, you know, he just financed it and just got it going.
Oh, I know him. I studied at the court of Lorenzo de' Medici when I first started here.
Yeah. Another guy who came here was Marcio Ficino. Now, he was the actual, like, leader of the academy, and he accomplished so many things. So such as he translated both Plato and Plotinus' famous works into Latin, which was the first translations of them in a Western language. And he also had many different ideas about Christianity, such as that there had to be an afterlife, because the non-existence of one just did not make sense with the perfection of natural order. And he published two works called The Three Books of Life and one called The Letters of Marcio Ficino.
Okay, guys, I gotta use the restroom. I'll be right back.
Bye. Lorenzo, come here. Even Pico went here, and he did some pretty cool stuff. Like, for example, he was a huge believer in humanism and was driven to find a deeper wisdom and understanding of God and what roles humans play in the universe. He wrote three books. One was called The Oration of the Dignity of Man. One was called Liber de Christiana, Religion. And the third one was called The Theology of Platonica. And, of course, he had those 900 theses, too.
That's all he ever talks about.
Oh my god, I know.
So yeah, like, Pico and his mom, like, who does he think he is?
What's
like,
up
just,
with him?
Like, I know what you're talking about. You know, just,
Michelangelo and Botticelli?
They're really great.
Michelangelo, he trained under some artists here, and, you know, he was taken under the wing of Lorenzo. He was really caring, and it was just really great. And so he learned all these different styles of art, and like, he learned about humanism, which really influenced him to strive for the perfection of the human body in his art. And then there was Botticelli, who went here, and he had some amazing paintings that really showed humanism and Christianity, like, you know, Primavera and the Birth of Venus. They were really great paintings. You should check them out sometime.
Oh, yeah.
They really agree with your 900 theses. It would be great. Those are some great theses.
This is one of the paintings I created. I mean, just look at the symmetrical boundaries and correct proportions. I call it the Last Supper.
Wow, your technique and use of realism give them such a natural feel. It inspires me to create something great.
Wow, you're such an overachiever, Da Vinci.
Hey, just believe it. Many and endless goals for myself. I travel all over until I find a place that suits my needs and my desire to excel.
Probably should go back to Tundra now.
Now, Da Vinci, not that it's been boring looking at your painting, but let's go downstairs and play Two Truths and a Lie.
All right.
Hey, Pico, we're going downstairs.
Okay.
Who wants to go first?
I mean, I guess I can.
You know how to play?
I don't know how to play.
Tell her how to play.
I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. Two truths, one lie, we pick which one's the lie.
Alright,
got it. Let's go. Okay, for my two truths and a lie, one. I stole a Medici's wife and ran away with her.
Ah!
Oh! I'm considered a perfect man in all aspects by many people.
That's a little bit, self-righteous.
Three. I'm against humanism. Which one's a lie?
I'm against three.
You guys are right.
Yay!
I guess I'll go now.
One. I painted the Mona Lisa using different techniques and it still remains popular. Two, I filled over 13,000 pages with theories, ideas, plans, and blueprints.
Three,
my favorite board game is Monopoly.
I'm gonna go with one.
Monopoly's pretty fun, but I mean, life's way better. I'm going with three.
You're right, it is three. My favorite board game is Scrabble.
Woo! Alright, I guess I'll take a crack at this. Okay. So, one. The Platonic Academy was a recreation of a group of philosophers that Plato had back in Athens, Greece. You know, back in the day.
Sounds legit.
Two. The Academy also taught interpretive dance from time to time. Michelangelo took lessons.
Nice.
Or three. The Academy consisted of everything from philosophers, artists, and students.
I've got this one. I'm gonna go with two.
I second that.
Yep, it's two. There's no interpretive.
Okay, I guess it's my turn. Number one,
One of the youngest people to attend the Platonic Academy was Michelangelo. Number two, Pico della Mirandola actually stole one of Lorenzo de' Medici's brother's wives. And three, the Platonic Academy was originally a wizarding school by the name of Hogwarts.
Well, we know it's not two, because I already went over that.
Three, I'm guessing that one's why.
Heck no, I'm guessing number one.
Well, Hogwarts is with Harry Potter.
Well, number three was the lie. Sorry, Da Vinci. Nice playing with you, though.
I think the teachers...
Guys, by looking at the time, I think we should probably get back to the tension. I don't want to get into
oh,
much
yeah,
trouble.
Oh, yeah, the teacher said he'd be checking back on. Not that
Let's
I can't,
go!
Because I'm a rebel.
Well, guys, back where we started. Gluten free, who knew? How did you guys get in here anyway?
Honestly, I don't even know why I'm here. I just know a lot about the Platonic Academy. It's almost like I wrote a paper on it or something.
Well, guys, I have a confession to make, and I think it's okay to tell you under our circumstances. To be honest, I'm not all I seem to be by my clothes and the way I act. My parents are actually very rich, and as a small child, I was given everything I could want or need. But as I grew older, I didn't want the special things I got, like a spot in the government and a church benefice that would have me set for life. Instead, I decided to travel around the world and completely change my look to break away from my parents' money. I wanted to make my own path in this world, not walk the one that my parents paved.
Wow, I never would have guessed that you've gone through all that. Like, it makes me see a whole different side of you.
Like, yeah, guys, I mean, I know I don't really say much, and, like, I haven't done much here. Like, I just know a lot about the academy, but, like, being here just really shows me how amazing the people are, and, like, just how much we go through just to show our humanistic views, and, like, it's so amazing how we just want to enlighten the people and just share all the amazing art and philosophy that we can do. Like, Pico was coming from his past and just creating his own future, and Leonardo with all his amazing art and stuff. It's just so great how we can just share this with people.
I know I come off as a brainiac and all, but I've really struggled, like, keeping up with everybody's expectations, what they want from me. So many people rely on me to help them command their military or create something newer, make brilliant artwork, and I try my best, but sometimes it's a lot.
I think even though we're all really different, I think we can all kind of tie back to the same things, like humanism and our love for creativity and following our own paths, and I think we all really shared something today.
Yeah, guys, I mean, I really think we've all come really far, and just, we've all really connected, and I mean, I get it if you don't really, like, talk to me in the hallway ever again.
What do you mean we wouldn't talk to you in the hall?
Really, Leonardo? You think you're gonna talk to me in the hallways?
Here, what do you mean I'm gonna talk to you in the hallway? We have so much in common that I can't throw this new friendship away. We both believe in striving for excellence, the power of humanism and individualism. We both know that creativity and the arts are important, and overall seeking knowledge is the main goal of mankind.
Alright, you guys are free to go if you finish your essays. I really hope you've learned something today, and I don't want to see you guys back here next Saturday.
So we didn't write our paper, so not to take advantage of you or anything, but would you write our paper for us?
I got you guys.
Thanks, man.
Claire, come with me.
Claire.
Yeah.
I've had a great time getting to know you and the Platonic Academy during our adventures in detention. I'll never forget you.
I won't forget you either, Pico.
After everything you've been through today, I won't forget you.
I'll never forget you.
So, Mr. Reuter, at the end of the day, we realize what we did was wrong. You may still view us as the stereotypes you believe us to be, a thinker,
a rebel,
a ruler,
but we know now that we are much more. Thank you for showing us that. Sincerely yours,
Il Club della Colazione.
AKA The Breakfast Club.